Hey guys, this is going to be a quick video answering a question of playmakers that I really did some research on for a few weeks. About 3 weeks ago, in the comments section of one of my videos, I think it was the one on Bithia, who raised or reared Moses, playmaker asked, what was Moses' actual name? In this quick video, I'm going to try to answer that based on what I've gathered, and I'm going to read a couple of things for you, and hopefully this will answer not only Playmaker's question, but if you've ever wondered, it'll answer your questions as well. But before we get started, be sure to like and subscribe for more videos like this, as well as my other videos on faith, health, and beauty all year round. So Moshe is the name that was given by Pharaoh's daughter, Bithia, to the baby she drew from the water. Since the Hebrew word for drew him, mishitihu, is linked with the word Moshe. So according to some sources, it was actually his biological mother, Jochebed, who gave him the name Moshe. Jochebed later told Pharaoh's daughter, Bithia, the child's Hebrew name, and so Bithia also called him by this name, remarking that this name was indeed appropriate since he had been drawn out of the water. Now, some sources say that Bithia gave Moshe the Egyptian name Munias, which the Torah translates into Hebrew as Moshe. Alternatively, it's also being suggested that the possibility that Bithia actually had learned to speak Hebrew, and it was she who gave Moses the Hebrew name. And its latter explanation is also given by some other commentators. And interestingly, Moses was actually called by no less than 10 names, and you'll see some of them actually listed in the Old Testament. Yahed, implying descent, and Miriam gave him this name. Because of him, she went down to the Nile to see what would become of him. Avogador, master of the fence, and he was called this by his grandfather because since Moshe's birth, God had fenced in Pharaoh, not allowing him to continue his decree to drown Jewish infants. Chaver, or companion or connector, because of his connection to the Jewish people. Avi Shochol, father of seers, and he was given this name by his grandfather Kehet as well. And some say actually the nurse who helped to raise him, because Moshe would grow up to be the master, or Avi, of the seers. Yakutil, from the root Kavi, meaning hope. And his mother Jochebed called him by this name because she had hope and trust in God that he would return Moses to her. Avi Zanoach, literally master of rejection. And Aaron, his brother, gave him this name, saying, my father rejected my mother, but took her back because of this child. Alternatively, it's being said because Moses would make Israel reject idols. Tovia, implying goodness, and the Jewish people actually call him Shemaiah, Ben, the son of Nathaniel. Also Ben Eviatar, son of pardon, since it was Moses, was the Jewish son who solicited God's pardon for the Jewish people's sin of the golden calf when he went up to Mount Sinai. And last but not least, believe it or not, Levi, so named after the tribe to which Moses belonged. So despite all these names throughout the Torah, he's referred to as Moses or Moshe. And God himself addresses Moses only by this name. So there you have it. How Moses came upon his name and the other names he's been called by throughout history. If this has been helpful for you and entertaining, be sure to like and subscribe for more videos like this, as well as my other videos on faith, health, and beauty all year round. Also, if you have other questions that you just can't find answers to, list them below, and I'll do my best to do research and check them out for you. Sometimes I'm learning at the same time you are. Sometimes I already know the answers, but this one, I knew part of the answer, but I didn't know about the 10 names, so thanks so much for asking, Playmaker. With that, continue to be happy, healthy, and whole. I'm Julie. See you next time.